Hi again, John Flores, and here we go with the Ronnie Dyson chapter. It's going to be kind of brief, but there are a couple good stories in terms of Ronnie that I want to share with you. One is, Ronnie was the star of a musical on Broadway called Hair, and the couple of songs from Hair were The Age of Aquarius and Let the Sunshine In, which Bones Howe cleverly combining the two tunes, and made what became for the Fifth Dimension a number one record and Record of the Year Grammy Award winner. Oh my. Well, Ronnie was the one that the Fifth, when they attended Hair, heard singing that and said, Bones, we want to do Aquarius. But Ronnie was very little known outside of Broadway circles. So when he signed with Columbia Records, they had Tom Bell, the fabulous producer for the Spinners, and the Stylistics and many others come in and do an album for him, and nothing much happened. So the way this story goes is that I went to my partner at the time, former promotion man of the year in the record business, Harvey Cooper, and I said, Harvey, go tell Mickey Eichner at Columbia in New York, who's your buddy, that I want to produce Ronnie Dyson for free. I love his voice so much, I'll do it for nothing. And Harvey calls me back a couple days later and says, I did you one better. I not only got your Ronnie Dyson for free, but if Columbia likes your project with Ronnie Dyson, they're going to give you one Johnny Mathis album for pay that will follow that. I thought, oh my God, is this great or what? So we went in the studio, Ronnie and I, we cut three tracks. One, an up-tempo Lambert and Powder tune, I Think I Must Be Dreaming. Another one, Life and Breath, by the group Climax with Sonny Geraci, who had been better known for their record Precious and Few. And then we cut something a little funkier with The Captain of Your Soul. The dates came out great. I thought I enjoyed the heck out of them. And I've been able to hype them more and make them more commercial in the last 4 or 5 years that I've been messing around with my old tracks, which you're very well aware of. Ronnie was delightful to work with. He sang the perfect pitch, lots of emotion, great ad-libs, and was a delight to work with. Just a charming, dedicated professional. Rest in peace, Ronnie Dyson. So if you haven't heard the cuts that Ronnie and I did together and Darnielle Pershing beautifully arranged, take a listen to these excerpts. And then if you want to check out the full versions, they're on my website here at YouTube. Okay? And again, thanks for watching. Take care, you guys. Bye-bye.
Still on. soul. If you believe in dreams enough, then they'll believe in you. That's what you used to tell me, so I know it must be